All right. So hopefully the audio is okay. Well, hello, friends. Whether if you're joining us live or after the fact, I'm Reverend Marcus J. Pernell. I'm the youth pastor at First Baptist Church Frankfort. And this is session number 2 of 4 with Gentle Yoga. And tonight, or at least today, whenever you're watching this, we're going to be using a wall. So feel free to pause this if you're watching this after the fact or whatever, to move yourself toward a wall, because that is where we're going to be spending time tonight. Similar to last week, if you need a mat or a blanket or a couple of pillows or things like that to make yourself comfortable, by all means, please do that. I want you all to be as comfortable as possible and to listen to your body and to meet it where it is at. And other than that, we'll go ahead and get started. We'll go ahead and move back toward our wall. We'll sit in an easy seated position. Let me move my watch so that does not bother us. So I'm up against my wall. Back is flat. I'm relaxed. You can sit crisscross applesauce. You can sit like this. If you want to lay down against the wall, totally fine. But we're just going to start in an easy position of your choosing. What I'd like to invite you to do is just to sit against the wall, nice and easy. If you're sitting down, or if you're sitting down, to put your hands in an easy seated spot, whether that is on your knees, in your lap. They can be palms up, they can be palms down. You can make the "it's gonna be okay" sign, because if you're like me, the past few days have been very difficult. And just to have that reminder of "it's gonna be okay." And also close your eyes, do a couple of cleansing breaths as you're able to, in through the nose, sipping in as much air as you can. And then exhaling. And just one more, just for good measure. Let's just hang out here just for a moment or two. Breathing easy on your own as you're able to, in through the nose, out through the mouth. And something for you to think about and to consider in our practice together. How are you doing? And taking that question away from the surface and digging deeper, how are you really doing right here, right now? If you had to be honest with yourself, are you in a good place mentally, emotionally, spiritually? Are you kind of in kind of a roller coaster place? Are you in a bad or crappy place? How are you doing right now? How are you actually doing? And if you'd like to, and if you need to scoot away from your wall a little bit, let's just invite some half neck rolls side to side, treating the neck like a pendulum, swinging back and forth. Maybe you got a lot of tension, a lot of stress that you hold in your neck. Just be kind to the body, be kind to the neck. Let's do some full circles, nice and slow. If you're like me, maybe you got some Rice Krispies, some snack, crackling and popping, not crapping. No, don't. No, hopefully your neck is not cracking. That's not good. That would not be good. And then let's go the other way. Then go back to center. Let's tuck the chin in toward the chest, toward the heart space. Let's do some shoulder rolls. You can still have an easy gaze with your eyes closed. You can have them open. Whatever makes you feel comfortable. And let's roll the other way. Maybe your shoulders are country. Yeehaw. No, maybe they're crunchy. Maybe I can use words. All right. So now let's scoot back toward the wall or wall space. And we're going to actually extend the legs out in front of us. And again, if you need to, if you need some more comfort, some more support for your back, whether if that is with your pillow, with your mats, or a bolster, by all means, please use that. But I'm going to have my back straight against the wall. I'm going to kind of drive my quads or my thighs into the ground. Sit up nice and tall. Point and flex my toes. Listen to my neighbor's water running. And then we'll just invite a sun salutation, or not a sun salutation, we'll salute the sun. So on an inhale, salute the sun or the moon or the clouds. And then on an exhale, let's melt forward, reaching for the toes. If you can reach your toes, great. If you can't, and you go to toward your ankles, that is great. If it's your shins, great. Meet your body where it's at. And if you can, try to keep your back nice and straight. And it's okay if you got a little bit of rounding, but if you can, try to keep it straight. Check in with your breath. Are you clenching your jaw? Are you holding your breath? Are you tensing up? Where can you release that tension and relax? Maybe you roll your jaw around, create a little gap in between your teeth. So when we get stressed out, or at least when I get stressed out, my breathing becomes shorter, faster, and without me realizing it, I'm like, hey, I'm adding to my stress and not realizing it, and I'm kind of pooped. And then on an inhale, all I want us to do is slowly unravel vertebrae by vertebrae, sit back up nice and tall against our wall. And then, and if you need a drink of your coffee, or whatever drink you have, that's fine too. What we're gonna do next is we're gonna take our feet, we're gonna spread the floor with them as far as you can go. This is not a contest, so if it's just here, that's okay. Or if it's just right here, that's also okay. Meet your body where it's at. What I want us to do is, again, sit up nice and tall. Notice where you might be feeling sensation. Maybe you feel sensation in the inner thigh, the adductors a little bit, which is what we'll kind of focus on. What we'll do on an inhale We're going to take the left arm. We're going to reach over and twist to the right. Focus on that left wall here, those left obliques. I'm going to try to keep my back up against the wall. If you have to round over a little bit, that's perfectly fine, no big deal. Just kind of stretching out the side right here. And if you can you try to keep that left hip on the ground? If it comes up, that's okay. But if you can you keep it on the ground? And then on an inhale, let's take an inhale, excuse me. And then on the exhale, go the other way. Same thing on this side. Try to keep that right butt cheek on the ground, that right hip. Stretching out the right obliques here. Maybe you pop and crack your toes. We'll dehydrate it. And then on your own, coordinating breath with movements, to be like a wallflower. Just sway back and forth, not taking out your doorknob, or potentially turning on your light switch. Just move and groove to your own rhythm. Still recording. Yes, I'm still recording. Just keep on moving at your own pace while I move. There we go. Okay, that's way better. And then once you come back to center, once you finish your wallflower movements, we'll come back to the center. And just as you're able to, we'll just melt forward. Now for me, I'm not always the best at this one these days. I will fully get my chest on the ground. But in the meantime, if you need props to prop yourself up, like a mat, like a chair, that is totally fine. Whatever makes you feel comfortable. I'll just hang out here for a second or two, listening to these nice, smooth, jazzy beats. And the goal with this particular stretch, it's a seated straddle, kind of focusing on the hamstrings a little bit in the abductors as well. And if you want, you can add some movement, moving to the left. Ooh! Make them hammy sing. Again, these are all suggestions. If you want to stay where you're at, stay where you're at. In the words of my yoga teacher, be your own explorer. You are the CEO of your body. So now let's take a deep inhale. And then on the exhale, let's slowly roll up vertebrae by vertebrae. Bring the legs in. Bring them in as slow as you can if you need to drag them. That's fine. Shake them out a little bit. Ooh, man, that made my hands sink a little bit too much. So now, there's no easy way to get on the wall. I will say that, and I'm only taking my socks off because these will leave marks on the wall, which I don't want. So what I like to do, we're actually going to go on the wall, legs on the wall. I like to basically get my butt up against the wall, or seated sideways, and just pop myself up. There's no easy way to get up, and that is okay. I'm going to try to shock myself too, because I'm right over my electrical outlet. I don't really feel like I should. So take your time getting up here. And again, if you need a pillow, if you need your blanket, just for support or for some support for your back, by all means, please do that. And if you can, try to get your butt as close to the wall as possible while still on the ground. And as far as your hands go, you can have them on your chest, on your stomach. You can knock your coffee over. You can have them out to the side. Does not matter. Actually, let's point and flex the toes a little bit. Maybe even make wall fart noises, and that's fine too. Wall farts are welcome. Might move them side to side, might wiggle the toes. That is okay. And again, checking in with the breath, seeing how we're doing there. Maybe we're not used to sitting up against the wall, and that is okay. I might feel tense. What I'd like to invite you to do, roll that jaw around. Great space, a little gap in between your teeth. And just let the wall support you. I don't know about you, but we need support. We all need support every now and then, something to lean upon. I was thinking about that. I was getting ready for tonight. And it's like, you know what? We're just going to spend some time on the wall. I think we could all use some support, something to lean on. And that's okay. So whenever you're ready, if you'd like to, you may just want to hang out here. And that's totally fine. We're going to do a little wall butterfly. If I can get my butt against the wall. So I'm gonna bring the soles of my feet together. Try to keep my butts on the ground. And if you want to, again, these are all suggestions, you can take your hands. If you wanna add a little more stretch here, you can take your hands and push your knees into the wall. If you wanna create some movement, you can do that as well. Or you can just simply sit here and be the beautiful wall butterfly that you are. You may throw in a cleansing breath or two. And then whenever you're ready, we'll actually scoot away from the wall a little bit. We're going to stretch the glutes out some. So I'm going to start with my right leg. You can start with whichever leg you want. Say that fast 5 times. So all I'm going to do, I'm kind of sitting not at the best angle, probably. That's okay. So I'm kind of at a 90 degree angle. And all I'm going to do is I'm going to take my right ankle, just prop that bad boy right on my left knee, right at the top of my knee. Get a nice little stretch right in here, right in the glute. So if you know what pigeon pose is, like on the ground, if that is something that's difficult for you and you want like a nice glute stretch, this is a fantastic alternative. And you can control the intensity if you want more of a stretch. Maybe you move your left leg off the wall, or if you want, you can actually thread your arms through and pull your left shin in, or you might extend your leg and make kind of a figure four. Whatever works best for you. Now, if you are in the pose that I'm currently in, if you want to add a little bit more of a stretch or a little bit more pressure, you can take your hand or hands and gently push in on the knee that's crossed over. And then just whenever you're ready, at your own pace, very gently, very, very gently, come back to center real quick, and then we'll do the same thing on the other side. I'm doing my left, you may be doing your right. And if you're like me, you may notice that one side is tighter than the other, which has been the case for me for some time. My left glute is always tighter than my right. I don't know why, but that's okay. Can't really see from this angle, but I hope you all are doing good. So just whenever you're ready, again, if you want to hang out here longer, that's totally fine. We'll actually start to wind down, maybe go for a little longer on Shavasana or horizontal life pause. So with this, you can do a few different things. Like last week, you may want to just You may just want to lay down flat on the ground. Using blankets, using your, the thing you put your head on, pillow, there we go. You may want to lay like this. You may want to come back up here to the wall and have your legs up against the wall. It does not matter. Whatever pose is comfortable for you, go ahead and get yourself situated in that pose. We will enter into our Shavasana. Or corpse pose or horizontal life pause. This is your time to do nothing. Because doing nothing is good. Perhaps you soften your gaze. If you're like me, sometimes I like to have, if not an eye mask on, I'll sometimes use like a little towel to put over my eyes because I can't put curtains up in my apartment, just to help relax me some. Just be held by the wall or by the earth, whatever you're doing. Thank you. So while you're in your shavasana, in your life pause, I'd like to invite you to listen to the following, which may sound like a very familiar text. The Lord is our shepherd. We shall not want. He makes us lie down in green pastures. He leads us beside still waters. He restores our souls. He leads us in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. And even though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, we will fear no evil, for you are with us. Your rod and your staff, they comfort us. You prepare a table before us in the presence of our enemies. You anoint our heads with oil, and our cups overflow. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Start to lengthen your breaths, paying attention to the body, and perhaps if you're laying down, you roll over to a side of your choosing, and you simply, very, very easily get yourself up. Or if you're laying down against the wall, you very slowly, very, very slowly bring yourself down into an easy seated position. And you can still sit against the wall if you want. You can come up from it. Does not matter. Whatever you prefer. And to close our practice for this evening, let's take one. We'll do one saluting the sun. So on an inhale, bring the arms up. Bring our hands together into prayer pose. And on the exhale, bring our hands to our hearts. I'm very thankful that you all have taken the time to. Terrible timing. I'm sorry. I'm very thankful that you all have taken the time to not only do some self-care, but to pay attention to your body and give it some love. The light in me sees the light in you, and I'm very thankful for you.
In that recording.